Okay, we're gonna finish up 3-3. So that's number 17 from 3-3's homework. 4-1 is calculator stuff. It will be very quick, so make sure you know how to punch stuff up on the calculator. And then 4-2 is actually a lot of work, a lot of homework problems, but it's also very quick. But you have to be able to practice. It's more translating the language. And if you do it properly, they go by very quickly. You're going to learn something that's going to be your best friend. If you do it right, it'll be probably the least painful thing you do all semester, if you do it right. Practice it the same way, it'll be a piece of cake on your chest. But you got to, from the start, don't fight it. Okay? Next Wednesday, we should be finished up with chapter 4 and get a review sheet for chapter 3, chapter 4. That'll be the day we get our quiz. There won't be a quiz practice that I will post. We'll do it in class. Okay, so we'll get a quiz on. I haven't decided what I'm going to actually put the quiz on. You'll know more by this Wednesday. Most important things, whether we're doing long division or the next thing we do in section 3.3, synthetic division. These two things, the dividend and the divisor. In synthetic division, the divisor will have to be a special kind of divisor, so we won't have a choice. But the dividend has to be in descending powers of the variables. The powers have to go from the biggest power to the smallest power. It can't be all scrambled up like this is here. This one is scrambled up. That would be from the biggest power to the smallest power. So this has to be rewritten. Insert placeholders with zero coefficients for missing powers. So if we look at this, we have x to the third, x to the second, x to the first, and this is x to the zero. All the powers from 3 down to 0, everybody's there. But it's just scrambled up. The divisor has x to the second and then x to the zero. It's missing x to the first. So the numerator, the dividend, it's all scrambled, so it has to be rewritten. The denominator is missing a placeholder. We're missing x to the first. So you need to rewrite both of them before you can even do the division. Okay? Your test question is going to be ready to go. Not going to mix it up on it. Your bonus question could look like this. And that just means you got to do that one extra step before you actually do it. And I wouldn't try to do it as I'm going to do the division. I would do it here. So the biggest power is 10x to the third. And then the next one is a negative. The signs matter. Negative 2x to the second. And then here's x to the first. Positive 5x. And then a minus 1. And that's being divided by, we have a 2x to the second. We need an x in the first, so we need a 0x. This one needs a placeholder, but it's a 0x, and then a plus 1. Now, long division. out here is the divisor. 2x to the second plus 0x plus 1. Underneath here is the dividend. 10x to the third minus 2x to the second plus 5 times x minus 1. All you focus on, the only thing you care about, is the first term of the dividend and the first term of the divisor. We have a 2, we want a 10. We have 2x squared, we want a 10x to the third. Focus on the 2 first. What times 2 makes 10? We need a 5. So we're going to have to multiply it by something with a 5. What times x squared makes x to the third? X to the first. So we're going to multiply. Our very first term is going to be 5x. 5x times 2x squared gives me 10x to the third. Now here is the best news of the day. 5x is going to start right here. Not because this is a 5x. It's because it's an x to the first. It's going to start where the x to the first column is going to be. Since my first value, my first term that I'm going to use is x to the first, it has to line up with the x to the firsts. So I only have one place value left to go. The quotient can at most be two terms. So as ugly as that problem looked just by looking at it, it's going to have at most two terms. But you have to now distribute 5x times all of this. You want, I hope you're able to go 5x times each one and then put it underneath. But if you're not, just write it on the side. It's 5x times 2x squared plus 0x plus 1. And you need that because, again, it's a placeholder. 5x times 2x squared is 10x to the third. 5x times 0x, and again, we need it because it's got to be a placeholder, is 0x to the second. And 5x times 1 is just 5x. Again, let's put it in there. 5x times 0x is 0x to the third, still a placeholder. 0 squared. X to the third plus 0x squared plus the 5x. The next step, long division, you subtract each one. If you did it right, these two should cancel out. 10x to the third minus 10x to the third, 0. Good. Negative 2x to the second minus 0x squared. So negative 2x squared minus 0 is just negative 2x squared. Okay. 5x minus 5x. 5x minus 5x, that would be plus 0x here. So I still need it, but I got to have their 0. It needs to be there because that's that placeholder in the x one, in the x column. And then you have that minus 1. Bring down the next one, minus 1. We started in the x column. So we only have one place value left to go, the constants. We have a 2x to the second. We want negative 2x to the second. So what times positive 2x squared is going to give me negative 2x squared? A negative 1. I have to multiply this right here times a negative 1 to make this add up to 0. So then next, and here's going to be minus 1. So now you multiply the divisor by negative 1. Negative 1 times 2x squared plus 0x plus 1. Negative 2x squared minus 0x and a minus 1. Subtract again. And I really, really, really want you to subtract the whole thing. So you have to put, no, you don't have to put parentheses. But if you're going to subtract the whole thing, there would be parentheses and you would distribute the negative each one. So make sure you distribute the negative each one. So you can see negative 2x squared minus the negative becomes positive. That better make a zero because that's what we pick, negative one. It does. 0x minus negative, that's just going to be zero anyway. Negative 1 minus negative 1, that becomes plus 1. Negative 1 plus 1, that's a zero. If the remainder is zero, that just means it went in evenly, which means it's a factor. You don't have to say anything about it being a factor, but the answer is 5x minus 1. There's no remainder. Okay. You got to be able to set up the long division, take care of the long division. That's number 17. This is my dog, and it was really creeping me out last night because she's asleep. She was snoring, and she has her tongue out and her eyes open, and it was really, really creepy. Bubbles, because she looks just like the cat that we had named Bubbles. So she's like Bubbles too. That is the creepiest thing I think I've ever seen. Do that. I will. I should have warned her. Soon as you see the words, there is a knife shortcut. Of course, yeah, they call it knives. There's a knife shortcut for longer, but only under certain circumstances. It has to be a special time. Prolongation of polynomials when dividing by divisors of the form x minus k. Now, this is not a horizontal shift or vertical. That's not a k that we do with the shift. Our old k. This is just divided by something that looks like x minus a k. So it has to be two terms. We can only divide by a binomial with two terms. It has to be an x to the first. It doesn't work on that last question. The last question, we were dividing by an x squared. It even only it had two terms, but it was an x squared. So we can't do synthetic division with that last question. That'd be long division. Synthetic division can work with an x to the first and then a constant. Okay. These two methods are crucial to the upper levels beyond this. Now, if you're not going there, well, sorry, but that's going to be on your next step. It's crucial to your next steps. It's crucial to your future, whether it be long-term future or short-term future. But if you can do this, if you can follow the algorithm, if you can multiply and add, if you can multiply and subtract, that's all this division is, whether it be long division or synthetic division. The pattern for synthetic division of a cubic polynomial, so this is just a cubic power three, the sum. Okay. That is exactly what it is. Ax to the third plus bx squared plus cx plus d by x minus k use the following path. K, a, b, c, d, bring down a, multiply k times a, bring down b plus ka, and we keep on going. Vertical pattern, add the term that pattern, multiply by k. Coefficients of the quotient, and then you have the remainder of the last term. But I got an Albanian. But do you see the errors? We're going to bring this one down. Then we go diagonally and we multiply. Bring it down, multiply, then we add. Then we multiply times this. And then we put it here, and then you add. And then you multiply right there, and then you add. Never did I say what times this is going to make that. You don't even have to do that like we do with long division. What times here is going to make this, and then you subtract. Is you're going to start with whatever this is, you bring it down, and then this is already part, this is already chosen because it's there. You just multiply, add, multiply, add, multiply, okay? So the example that we're going to do, right there, algorithm for synthetic division only works if the divisor is an x to the first minus a number. Now, we did this in the co-reg. We did it with long division. And it probably took about, I don't know, 10, 15 minutes with long division. First of all, I scrambled. Second of all, it was missing a power. So there's two things that had to be fixed before it could even do it. So this one, it's not scrambled, but it's still missing a power. So before you can even start, it's actually x to the fourth, we're missing x cubed, plus 0x to the third minus 10x squared minus 2x plus 4, and we're dividing by x plus 3. Okay. First step can only be used if the divisor is of the form x minus k. So again, x to the first. And it's got to be a 1 times x. Let me make sure I point that out. In other words, would need to be a 1 times x to the first. If it's not a 1, we got to do some factor. If it's not an x to the first, you can't even do it. But if it's not a 1, we'd actually like to do some fraction factor. We have to convert a little bit. But it's got to be a 1 times x to the first. Then step two. Number two, rewrite if necessary. The dividend in descending powers and placeholders. So if we have missing powers, we need placeholders. And sorry, if we have missing powers, we need placeholders. And if it's not in the right order, you've got to put it in the right order. So we rewrote it. We had the placeholder 0x to the third. Yes.
Just back to step one. Even if so, if it was x to the first plus k, it wouldn't work.
We'll get
It has to
I'm
be.
getting there. I have x plus 3, don't I? Obviously, I wouldn't be doing this example if I couldn't show you it with this example. Don't get this answer right here. But you are onto something, or it's actually going to give you some horrible flashbacks to the past. Okay. Next step. Number three. Draw. Oh, sorry, I'm just familiar with this. Make the box. One thing at a time. Just make the box. That's not even a box. It's like a half a box. Right here, I want you to just make a box. Right there. Little quarter box. And step four, you're going to put K in the box. So now we're going to address the idea of the K. So this over here, the divisor is X plus 3. And we can only work with synthetic division if it's X minus a K. I don't know why I'm having trouble making K. K is enough. My K's aren't okay. I'm with K's. That K's built in. The divisor, it's X minus K always. So if I have X plus 3, what is K?
Positive.
Negative. Because the only way to get a positive in here, it would be in this form. It would have to be X minus already. To become a positive 3, it's X minus, the K is a negative 3. What is being subtracted? Because the negative would already be there. What would have to be subtracted from X to end up with a positive 3? K would have to be a negative 3. It would be the opposite sign. It's the opposite sign. For the synthetic division, K is the opposite sign in that divisor. It's the opposite sign in the divisor. If you have X minus 4, then K is equal to positive 4. If you have X plus 8, then K is equal to negative 8. Opposite sign. Okay. So right here, we're divided by X plus 3. So maybe I'm going to make K is negative 3. So start there. Make sure you write it down so you don't just glance at it and hope to get it right when you first do the problem, first set it up.
Then you also need to
find
out
how
X plus 3 equals 0.
You can do that. X plus 3 equals 0. Solve for X. We get X equals negative 3. That's fine. So now, put K in the box. Negative 3 is going to go right there. The next step, all you have to do is list the coefficients, not the X, just the coefficients. Coefficients are the numbers times the variable. So you're just going to list the coefficients of the derivative. So it's step number 5. Just right here, next to the box, make sure you're neat about it. What's the coefficient of this X to the 4? 1. Then the 0. Then the negative 10. Then the negative 2. And then the 4. Just the coefficients. And you want to have, written nicely because you're going to do some work underneath. So now bunched up. You don't want to look at this. Oh, I have a 10 here. You shouldn't have a 10 because it's a 1 X squared. I didn't see a 10 X squared anywhere. That's a 10 X squared. I'm looking at 10 X squared right there. Sorry, it's an X to the 4. So I didn't see a 10 X to the 4. See, maybe. And I know I get very literal about this, but step 6. Draw the line. So not right here, but give yourself a little bit of room. Draw the line right there. And then we begin. So it's all of this is the setup. First of all, can we even use synthetic division? On your test, you will be told. Do this one with long division, do this one with synthetic. So you'll know. Same thing with the bonus question. So you'll know. Rewrite a misstep. We rewrote it. Made the box, put K in the box. That was done. Just listed the variables. Drew a line. That's seven. Bring straight down. Just bring down. The first coefficient. Bring that one. It's going to go straight on down. You got a one. And the rest of it is the rest of the algorithm. We're going to take that coefficient. And you're going to take this and you're going to multiply times the box. And you're going to add it to the next column. So right here, we're going to do 1 times that negative 3. 1 times negative 3 is negative 3. And then you're going to go straight down, and you're going to add 0 plus negative 3 is negative 3. So you take that one, you multiply times what's in the box, you add it to the next column, and you repeat. So we take negative 3, and we're going to multiply this negative 3 with that negative 3. We get positive 9, and then you're going to add negative 10 plus negative 9 is negative 1. And then we're going to go diagonal. We're going to repeat. Negative 1 times negative 3. That's positive 3. And then we're going to add. Negative 2 plus 3 is positive 1. And then we're going to go again, multiply. 1 times negative 3 is negative 3. And then you're going to add 4 plus negative 3 is 1. That last number is the remainder. All of these other numbers are the coefficients. So here's what we have. Fair black and clean or something. I'm just going to try it here. Numbers. The numbers to be. The last number. The remainder. Numbers to the left. Coefficients. The coefficients of the quotients. The quotient starts 1 degree less than the dividend. A lot of vocabulary words thrown at you. You don't know your vocabulary, so it'll be Charlie Brown's teacher going womp 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 womp. So we just divided that. It took longer to write it out than to do it for. Make sure you can. And we're divided by, you know, an x plus 3 and we can equal. Make sure it's in order. Make sure all the powers are there. Everything's good. We're ready to go. What is, you know, drew the box, k in the box, k is negative 2. List the coefficients of the dividend. So 1, 0, negative 10, negative 2, 4. Draw the line in the middle. And then we went, bring down that first one. Multiply, we get negative 3. Add them up, 0 plus negative 3, negative 3. Negative 3 times negative 3, that's positive 9. Negative 10 plus 9, negative 1. Negative 1 times negative 3, positive 3. Add them up, negative 2 plus 3 is positive 1. 1 times negative 3, negative 3. 4 plus negative 3 is 1. We took x to the 4th, and we divided by an x to the 1st. So the power of the answer is going to be 1 degree less, because x to the 4th divided by x to the 1st is going to be x to the 3rd. 1 degree less would be x to the 3rd, and it would be 1, there's a coefficient, times x to the 3rd, minus 3x to the 2nd, minus 1 times x, and then plus x to the 0, 1 times x to the 0, 3, 2, x to the 1st, x to the 0, and then I have a remainder of 1 over the divisor of x plus 3. Now, please, you will lose points if you don't resimplify. 1 times x to the 3rd is just x to the 3rd. Minus 3x squared. 1 times x to the 1st is just minus x. Plus x to the 0 is just 1. This is just 1 times 1, so just plus 1. Plus 1 over x plus 3. Which is what we got this morning. That took 15 minutes. That took longer because we had to write out, I had to write out all the steps. But the steps aren't that bad once you just get it going. I mean, I'm hitting you with heavy vocabulary, like put K in the box. But I'm also hitting you with, is the dividend in order and is the divisor in the right form? Is it a circus or is it a college? I don't know. Which one of the people, which one are we at? Madera Community Circus or Madera Community College?
I'm just trying this book.
Yeah. That's my chance. Fun is not in the SLOs. Nothing better feeling than getting something right. Because you know everything else in my life is wrong. So that math is right and actually is. So that right there is the example. So let's do 24, 26, 28. Five x to the third plus 18 x squared, 7x minus 6. And that is being divided by x plus 3. Six. Well, first thing I'm going to do is x to the third, x to the second, x to the first, x to the zero. It's in order. All the powers are there. This is x plus 3, so it's x to the first, 1 times x to the first, and it's just 2 terms. So that's good to go. Maybe I'm going to write this. What does the k equal here? It's a negative 3. I wish I would have picked one that was a minus, but I don't see what I'm doing. So remember, if it was a minus, then your k would be positive. So we draw the box. We put k in the box. K is a negative 3. Then you write down the coefficients of the dividend. So we have a 5. We have an 18. You don't have to put the plus. You just put the coefficients. 5, 18, the 7, and the negative 6. We draw a line. And then we start. So everything we did in that first example took longer because I was writing all that stuff out. Bring down the 5. Then we multiply. So hopefully you don't have to draw the arrows, but if you do, that's fine. So you bring down the 5, and then we go 5 times negative 3. And you don't have to show this step, but somebody's going to say, well, where'd it come from? So 5 times the box, 5 times negative 3, I get negative 15. And then remember, this one is different than long division. Long division, you subtract. Here, you add. What's negative 18? Sorry. What's 18 plus negative 15? We get 3. Then we multiply again. We get 3 times that negative 3, and we get negative 9. And then we add 7 plus negative 9.
Negative 2.
Negative 2. Then we multiply.
that negative 2 times negative 3. And we get positive 6. Remember, this last number is the remainder. Negative 6 plus 6. What do we get? We get a remainder of 0, which means it goes in evenly. So the answer is, it was x to the third. So the quotient's going to start with x squared. It's 5x to the second plus 3x to the first minus 2.
And that was pretty quick.
Compared to the log additions of it. You have to think, what number am I going to use to multiply times the divisor? Then I got to go through and I got to do the distribution. Then I got to go through and do the subtraction of each one. Here, it's just you got to list everything, multiply, add, multiply, add.
On 26, the divisor is x plus 6, so that's good to go. X to the third, x to the second, x to the first, constant, all the powers are there, and it's in the right order. You notice I wrote 26 as a fraction.
The dividend is the numerator. The divisor is the denominator. Again, starting with, if I'm dividing by x plus 6, then k is equal to negative 6. So I draw that box, put k in the box. The coefficients are 2, 14, negative 20, and a positive 7. Draw the line. And what do I do first?
Bring down the
2. Bring down the 2. And then we go 2 times that negative 6, which gives us negative 12. And then we add. 14 plus negative 12 is 2. And then multiply 2 times negative 6 again, gives us negative 12. And negative 20 plus negative 12. Three.